In this session, we are going to see about network topology in computer networks. The topology, what is topology? It refers to the layout of connected devices on a network. So, some logical layout of topology: mesh, star topology, bus topology, ring, tree, and hybrid topology. So, these are the pictorial representation of the topologies: bus, second one is ring, and third one is star, and fourth one is extended star, and fifth one is hierarchical, and sixth one is mesh. So mesh topology, here every device has a point to point link to every other device. Node must be connected with n minus 1 nodes. So all the nodes are connected with all other nodes. A fully connected mesh can have n into n minus 1 by 2 physical channels to link n device. It must have n minus 1 IO ports. So advantages of mesh topology: they use dedicated links, so each link can only carry its own data load, so traffic problem can be avoided. It is robust. If any one link get damaged, it cannot affect others. It gives privacy and security, that is, message travels along a dedicated link. Fault identification and fault isolation are easy. So this is mesh topology. Here in this picture, six computers are connected with all other computers. So one computer is connected with another five computers directly through dedicated lines. So mesh topology disadvantages: the amount of cabling and number of ports, IO ports, require are very large, since every device is connected to each device via dedicated link. The sheer bulk of wiring is larger than the available space. Hardware required to connect each device is highly expensive. Then application: telephone, regional office, and WAN, wide area network. The next one is star topology. Here each device has a dedicated point to point link to the central controller called hub, act as a exchange. There is no direct traffic between devices. The transmission are acquired only through the central hub. When device 1 wants to send data to device 2, first sends the data to hub, which then relays the data to the other connector device. In star, this is the pictorial representation of star topology. There is a central hub. All the systems are connected to the hub. So printers, systems, everything are connected to the hub. So advantages of star topology: less expensive than mesh, since each device is connected only to the hub. Installation and configuration are easy. Less cabling is needed than mesh. Robustness: easy to fault identification to remove parts. No disruptions to the network then connecting, removing devices. Then disadvantages of star topology: even it requires less cabling than mesh when compared with other topologies, it's still large. Dependency: when it goes down, the whole system is dead. Application: star topology used in local area networks, LAN. High speed LAN often used star. Then bus topology. The bus topology is multi-point. Here one long cable acts as a backbone to link all the devices or connected to the backbone by drop lines and taps. Drop line. What is drop line? Drop line is a connection between the devices and the cable. Then tap. Tap is a splitter that cut the main link. This allows only one device to transmit at a time. So a terminator is there, nodes and the line, main line. So T connectors are used. This is a T connectors. T connectors are used to connect a node from a main line. So this is the picture of a bus topology. So this is a common bus: terminator, sender, receiver. At the time, only one system can send a message. A device want to communicate with other device on the network, sends a broadcast message onto the firewall. Other devices see, but only the intended devices accepts and process the message. So advantages: easy of installation, less cabling. And disadvantages: difficult reconfiguration and fault isolation, difficult to add new devices, signal reflection at top can regradation in quality. If any fault in backbone can stops all transmission. So applications: most computer motherboards. Then ring topology. Here each device has a dedicated connection with two devices on either side. The signal is passed in one direction from device to device until it reaches the destination, and each device have repeater. When one device receives signals instead of intended another device, its repeater then regenerates the data and passes them along. To add or delete a device requires changes only to connections. So this is the picture of ring topology. So this is a ring. All systems are connected in a single ring. So this is the ring topology having two connections. One is primary ring and another one is secondary ring. So the flow of messages is in one direction only. It cannot be reversed. Easy to install, easy to reconfigure, fault identification is easy. And disadvantage: unidirectional traffic. As I said, the data are transmitted in one direction only. Break in a single ring can break an entire network. And applications: it is found in office buildings or school campuses. High speed LANs made this topology less popular. Then tree topology, alternatively referred to as star bus topology. Tree topology is one of the most common network setups that is similar to a bus topology and a star topology. A tree topology connects multiple star networks to other star networks. Below is a visual example. You can see it is a simple computer setup on a network using star topology. So this is a tree topology. One system is connected with another systems. It's a tree like structure. And hybrid topology: a network which contain all type of physical structure and connector under a single backbone channel. So any kind of topology is mixed with another topology. We can say it is a hybrid topology. More than 2, 3, 4 topologies can be mixed in a single topology. So this is a hybrid topology. So in a single backbone there are number of topologies. This is a ring topology, this is a bus topology. So all these are, this is a star topology, all these are connected in a single backbone cable. That is called hybrid topology. Thank you.